They really felt as if they had lost a friend, for the dragon had been both kind and sociable during their brief acquaintance with him, but they knew it was his duty to return to his own country. So they went back to the caverns to renew the search for the hidden passages that led to the forest. But for 3 days, all efforts to find them proved in vain. It was Polychrome's custom to go every day to the mountain and watch for her father, the Rainbow, for she was growing tired with wandering upon the earth, and longed to rejoin her sisters in their sky palaces, and on the third day, while she sat motionless upon a point of rock, whom should she see slyly creeping up the mountain but Ruggedo? The former king looked very forlorn. His clothes were soiled and torn, and he had no sandals upon his feet or hat upon his head. Having left his crown and scepter behind when he fled, the old gnome no longer seemed kingly, but more like a beggar man. Several times had Ruggedo crept up to the mouth of the caverns, only to find the 6 eggs still on guard. He knew quite well that he must accept his fate and become a homeless wanderer, but his chief regret now was that he had neglected to fill his pockets with gold and jewels. He was aware that a wanderer with wealth at his command would fare much better than one who was a pauper, so he still loitered around the caverns wherein he knew so much treasure was stored, hoping for a chance to fill his pockets. That was how he came to recollect the metal forest. "Aha!" said he to himself. "I alone know the way to that forest, and once there, I can fill my pockets with the finest jewels in all the world."